privilege to have amongst us our chief guest, IAS SDO of Dover, Sri Dipankar Chaudhary. Sir, we welcome you and kindly ask you to come on the stage and illuminate us. Sir, please.
Good evening. Good evening, respected Secretary Maharaj, Dr. Ganguly, Principal Maharaj, and all the parents and students present here. Thank you very much for inviting me on this auspicious day. Speaking on Teachers' Day is a difficult task. I'm not a teacher. I've had quite a few fabulous teachers in my life, but I'm definitely not one. What I would rather do is that I will tell you three simple small stories from my life, my own personal experience, about the quality of teachers which made a profound difference in what I am today. They made me the person I am. I'll begin early on when I was a small kid. You know, it's a common fear, it's a common phobia among small kids when it comes to mathematics. Students are always scared of mathematics, not just students, even adults are scared of mathematics. I'm pretty sure a lot of you present in the audience here are still scared of mathematics. So as a small kid, my parents wanted me to learn mathematics and they wanted me to solve questions which were not of my class, my standard. Let's say if I was in standard 6, they wanted me to solve questions which were of standard 8. Now, for someone who is already fearful of mathematics, if you present to that person a book or a question which is supposedly 2 grades above him, then he will be terrified. So I had a teacher. He took out questions, he explained concepts to me, but he never told me which standard or which grade they were from. He was my grandfather, by the way, and in that way I was taught mathematics. All of a sudden, I was thrown a standard 8 book while I was still in standard 6 and told to solve. I was terrified, but then I was told that we have already solved half of the book. If you go back past 1 month, you will realize that you have already solved half of the questions here. Now, what are the learnings which we draw from here? I leave that up to you. It's for the teachers here present and for the students here present to draw learnings out of this experience. But I would say that this experience from a teacher of guiding me in difficult situation without even letting me know that I was in a difficult situation was one of the profound effects in my life. Another one which I remember very starkly and which is very recent is that when I was under my police training, I used to be an IPS officer before I joined the Indian Administrative Service. And it so happened once that while riding a horse, I fell from a horse and injured my spine. I was in the hospital for 2 weeks. And I had lagged behind in my training for about 14 days, 15 days compared to my other course mates. I had to compensate for that. There was also this remote possibility that I will have to quit training and come back another year after a surgery and do my training again. I was terrified. You know, if you join the civil services, especially IPS, you have trainers who are known as drill instructors. In other words, in Hindi we call them Ustad. Ustad hote hain IPS Academy mein jo aapko sari training karate hain. Just right after I was out of from my bed, I had a 10 kilometer race coming up after 20 days. I was not ready for that. But I had to complete that race, that run, for the sake of my training. The very first day when I tried running, I could hardly run for 100 meters. But there was this Ustad, a very fine head constable from BSF, who was with me all the time. He took me on small runs. He ran with me continuously for 20 days. Initially, I could not carry my weapon because that's a heavy weapon to carry. And you have to run with your weapon. At the end of 20 days, I was able to complete the race along with my weapon. I was not the first one. I was also not the last one. I was not among the average performers also. I was somewhere in the last quadrant. It didn't matter to me because I had completed a race. A lot of the others had time to prepare for that race for very long. But I was just out of hospital after a bed rest of 15 days, who simply couldn't walk, and I had completed that race. What inferences you draw from here, I leave it up to you. I leave it up to the teacher and to the student to draw what inferences you can draw from this relationship between a teacher and a student. But again, this had a very profound effect on me. You have a very talented batch. Very soon, a lot of you will be leaving this institution. Some of you must be in class 10, some of you must be in class 12. You would be leaving this institution and joining various, taking various career paths. Doctors, administrators, policemen, scientists, journalists, artists, sportsperson, lawyers. I hope we have a mixed crowd here. I simply don't want to see doctors and engineers filling every crowd, filling every room. So once you are out from this institution, you probably will realize what your teachers have contributed for you. It won't be very clear to you, it will come to you subconsciously. When you are in trouble, when you are down, when you are in a place where you don't see a way out. But this institution would have given you so much. Your teachers, your peers would have given you so much here that will automatically guide you. You won't have to put conscious efforts to remember what your principal Maharaj or your secretary Maharaj or the other monks or what your teachers taught you. You won't have to think and meditate, sit and think and meditate about that. It will come to you subconsciously. And believe me, you, that will be your guiding light. I can say this with, let me take this opportunity to say that right now all of you are in a very protected environment. The world out there is not going to be this simple. It is going to be a very harsh and difficult world, especially in this day and age. And I am confident that the teachers who are present here in this academy, in this institution, are preparing you in the right way and right manner for all the challenges which befall you once you step out of this institution. So think of this institution as a launch pad, I would say. It will help you launch in whatever direction you wish to go. Any direction you wish to go. And I want to congratulate again for all the superstars who have been performing since the evening began. It has been a very lively performance. I am looking forward for more. All the very best to all of you. Looking forward to interacting with you sometime soon, maybe in a different setting, maybe in a more informal setting. Nevertheless, all the best to you. Thank you. Good night.